Hello everyone, welcome to Paranormal and Spiritual World. Today we'll talk about the most powerful mantra that will give you everything, whatever you want in this life. And I've already uploaded this video in Hindi language for the people, so you can browse the same from the below link. And let's start the video. So this mantra is one of the most powerful, most sacred mantra. And no matter where you belong, whatever you believe in, you can chant this mantra, because this mantra in the Hindu Dharma is one of the most important mantra being used in tantric practices, in tantra, in rituals, in religious ceremonies, even for your own well-being, for spiritual awakening, even to attain the state of nirvana. So without any delay, let me first tell you about the mantra, what exactly the mantra is and how to pronounce this mantra. This mantra is basically connected with three goddesses: Goddess Saraswati, Goddess Lakshmi and Goddess Kali. The mantra chants as follows: Om Aim Hreem Kleen Chamundai Vichche. So I'll be giving you this in the written format below the link in the description probably. So you can see from there, you can write down from there and you can try to pronounce it. This mantra, Om, Aim, Hreem, Kleen, Chamundai, Vichche, this represent three goddesses. So as I told you before, first of all, the goddess Saraswati, known to provide knowledge, wisdom, education. Everyone know this fact that without knowledge, without education, without self-awareness, and it's not just about knowledge of books and all, it's about knowledge of yourself, knowledge of your surroundings, knowledge of the purpose of life. So if you have the brain, you have a very sharp brain, no matter you have studied or not, you will be able to live the life, you will be able to tackle all the problems in your life, you will be able to discover anything, you will be able to construct anything, you will be able to innovate anything. So brain knowledge is really, really important for yourself, for your own wisdom and to achieve wisdom actually. Second Shakti, which is associated with this mantra, power, Deity, is Goddess Lakshmi, which represents wealth, money, luxury, status. In this life, in this materialistic world, you need money in order to survive. Even if you have that money of survival, then next stage which really comes towards you is luxury, fulfilling your desires, attaining that status that will initially give you that pride. And each and every person in this world is running after money. We all need it in order to live this life, to live this life comfortably, fulfilling our dreams. So this mantra gonna give you that opportunity as well. And then comes the third Shakti, the third power associated with this mantra is of Goddess Kali, that represents destruction of your enemies, power, discipline, strength. Even any person in this world, everyone generally have some or the other issues in their life, connected to people, connected to enemies, connected to opponents. It can be in the competitive market, or it can be in the family itself, it can be anywhere in any form. This goddess Kali also nullifies every kind of tantra, black magics being done by your opponents or enemies. So over here you see these three powers giving you almost everything. You are getting knowledge, you are getting money, and you are getting power to defeat your enemies. Your enemy is going to get defeated automatically. And each and every person in this world dreams actually of this kind of life, where they are super intelligent, super rich, and there should be no enemies. Everybody generally thinks about this thing, that it maybe it's a dream, or maybe it can be in a factual sense. only and only by extreme hard work or by some kind of help of the God. So this is one of the most sacred mantra which can really help you in achieving the status of being powerful, of being rich, of being intelligent, of being knowledgeable, of being powerful enough to defeat your enemies, of being having that amount of strength and courage that you will be able to face your opponents and competitors and rivals in the society. So this mantra can be chanted by anyone, anytime, any number of times. Either you chant it through a mala, or you can through any mala of beads. Generally that consists of 108 beads, counting to have that pronunciation. Representing one mala is equal to 108 beads. You can do like that, or you can generally, in a general manner, you can chant this mantra without any mala or without calculating the number of times you're chanting, because I generally prefer the purpose of doing any mantra is calling upon that power. So I really do not think that we should categorize those shaktis, those powers, into a form of mathematical coordination. Instead, we should generally just simply chant that mantra with full sensitivity, with full emotions and depth towards that power, that we are calling them for help, we are calling them for strength, we are calling them to be with us. So there should be no mathematics involved in this thing, that I have done this number of chants or that number of chants. So all that thing really look planned to me, and things do not work like that in spiritual world. You cannot plan anything. You really need to be spontaneous, you really need to be uncalculative towards getting any help from spiritual side. So simply chant this mantra as much as you can. You can do it anytime, night, day, anytime. But one of the most important thing which I really need to tell you is that this mantra is really, really powerful, and you will see the changes in your life once you will start chanting this mantra. But in order to make it successful in your life, you really need to make changes in your own self as well, in your own well-being, in your own surroundings, in your own lifestyle. If you're consuming non-veg, if you're consuming meat, egg, liquor, fish, chicken, pork, any kind of animal dead body, if you're having as a food, so this mantra will not be as successful as you are thinking. The concept is really, really remarkable, but it works only for the people who are pure in terms of their body, in terms of the things they are using in their lifestyle. For example, if you are eating non-veg, you are again and again doing a karma where a lot of animal dead bodies are being consumed by your body and your soul. So that really is not connected to this mantra. So definitely the power, the kind of blessings you are expecting from this mantra will be reduced because of your non-veg consumption and your liquor consumption. So you really need to get rid of non-veg and egg as well as liquor in order to get the full blessings, full effect of this mantra. Secondly, you really need to become calm, you really need to become peaceful, you really need to change your attitude. If you have an attitude of fighting with people, if you have an attitude of being argumentative, being opinionative about others, being too much judgmental, being or you are into frequent quarrelsome attitude you are carrying since a long time, try to change that. Try to be helpful to others, try to be a good human being. And this may take a while to you, because if you have a kind of upbringing, if you have a kind of attitude which you have been carrying since a very, very long time, of being arrogant, of being loud, or being of too much aggressive nature, so definitely it will take time to make yourself a better human being who is away from every kind of quarrels, fights, blame games, and abusive nature. You have to get rid of all that. And once you will achieve that state, this mantra will work like magic for you. You will see spiritual changes, you will see materialistic changes, you will see powers coming within you. You will be able to, even if you will be saying something, that particular word, particular sentence will become true, will become an act of future. It's like a God's voice being saying something. So this power of this mantra works like magic, but it really wants you to sacrifice every negative thing, every negative karma which you have been doing since a very long time. So you really need to get rid of all those negative habits from your life, and you have to be a good human being, and then chant this mantra. Because this mantra, a lot of people take these mantras for granted. They think that they can do anything in their life, they can do any bad karma and still get blessings of the shaktis, of the deities, of the powers associated with the mantras. But things does not happen like this in spiritual world. If you really want to attain full success of any power, of any shakti, of any god or goddesses or their mantra you're chanting associated with them or with their blessings, you really need to amend yourself too, in order to get the full benefit, in order to get the full complete blessings of that particular mantra. Talking about this mantra, you really need to change yourself, you really need to behave in a sober manner. And by doing that, by making changes in your lifestyle, by being sattvic, by being pure from inside as well as outside, away from every kind of bad habit, you will be chanting this mantra and you will be attaining that spiritual bliss which you have been longing for since a very long time. And you will see magical changes in your life. You will see amazing improvements in your life. You will see yourself being connected to God. You will see that your enemies are being defeated again and again by themselves only. You will see that your each and every word is getting true. You will see that even in a case you are being entrapped or in any dispute or in problem, you will be just taken out from that, since just like magic. And you will see your long time back wishes gonna get fulfilled, all those things, even if they are the materialistic wishes. Because this mantra will give you wealth, success, luxury. This will give you knowledge to attain that power, to know things, to create something, to create discovery. Maybe you will discover something that will be a fruitful for you, for even for your generations. And it will even give you that power to get rid of your enemies. So this is the complete package for your whole life to make it a successful life. Again, I am ending this video by chanting this mantra, and I will be giving this in English letters in the description, so you can note down this mantra and even chant. And for the viewers who generally enjoy watching my Hindi videos, I've already uploaded this video in Hindi language, and I will be giving you the link in the comment section, so you can browse from there. So again, I am chanting this mantra. Om Aim Reem Kleem Chamundaye Vichche. So this is beautiful, this mantra is beautiful. And so do comment in the at the end of the video if you like today's video, and try to use this mantra for your well-being, and try to make that necessary changes which I have advocated in this video. So I hope you enjoy today's video. So keep on watching. I am Pulkit Mohan Singla. For any consultancy regarding paranormal issues, you can contact the given numbers below. Thank you so much.